What's up, guys? It's Parallax Abstraction, and welcome to PXA Peeks at Bullet Soul. You know what I haven't covered much on this channel? Shmups. And you know what I really enjoy, despite being terrible at them? Shmups. And well, I've got a new one here for you, or rather new to the PC anyway. This is a game that originally came out on the Xbox 360, originally as a retail release in Japan only, and then it became downloadable sometime later. So as you can see there, this actually dates back to 2011. And this is the PC release of it, which has just come out. And it's got kind of a mixed reception in the shmup community. Some people say it's pretty basic, doesn't do anything too innovative, and it's just kind of meh. Others say similar things, but that it's very good at what it does. And it does bring a couple of little innovations with it. I tend to fall into the latter category. It's not my favorite shmup ever, but it's pretty decent. And I'm going to show it off to you guys today. So, one little thing here that's a little weird from a technical perspective, despite having all of these different options to scale and position the screen and do smoothing and turn like the score UI into different configurations and whatnot, this game is locked at 720p on the PC. Yeah, so that was the resolution it originally ran in on the Xbox, and I guess it was too hard to make this engine scale up or whatever. So yeah, if you're, no matter what your monitor is, you're going to be playing this at 720p on the PC. I still think the game looks and runs okay in spite of that, but just so you know, that's going to cause an issue for some people, I'm sure. So I'm not going to screw around with these options. Needless to say, though, there are quite a few of them, and this customizability I quite like. It does can play with the keyboard. I'm playing with an Xbox One controller, which does work fine, which I'm very happy to see, because there have been problems with that with some older ports of games. And another nice thing is that this game comes with all of the DLC that you had to pay extra for in the 360 version, which is really nice. So you've got the core game, you've got Bancho mode, which is a single stage score attack mode, you've got Caravan mode. Caravan is a mode that you see in a lot of Japanese shmups. It's basically a timed score attack. So you're dropped into a stage and your goal is to go to get as big a score as you can in the time allotted for leaderboard progression. There's also what's called version B, which is, they define it as a refined mode with new enemy placement, rebalanced difficulty, and an emphasis on greater thrills. It's a lot easier, in my opinion, than the core game. So, and there's also a fourth ship available in this mode as well, which actually makes it kind of a breeze. But again, and there's a Bancho mode for that as well. So I like the variety. You know, it gives you different ways to play it. A lot of shmups do this, especially shmups that have had multiple versions in arcades and things like that, which I really like. There is also a training mode, which allows you to pick your stage, how many lives you have, what power level your shots are at, and how many bombs you have. It's just for practice. I like that as well. And of course, you've got the main game, which we're going to dive into here. So you have multiple characters you can pick from, which have different types of gun configurations, as you can see. So there's multiple types of shots, one which you get by mashing the fire button quickly, and then this is what's called here that you can see is the wide shot, which you get by holding the button down. So if you hold the button down, it will continuously fire, but in a different, less intensive configuration than if you mash the button, which is kind of cool. It also has what's called auto bomb. So like most shmups, you do have screen clearing bomb attacks that you have a limited number of. Auto bomb just means when you get hit, it will automatically drop a bomb as opposed to you dying. Which is interesting, but does change things a little bit. Does have two-player local only multiplayer. But even if you're playing on your own, you can choose to play on a different side of the screen if you want. So each of these characters are a little bit different. They all have different gun configurations and whatnot. They all have these portraits, as you can see. And they all have unbelievably infuriating voice acting. Oh my god, it's awful. It's very shrieky, and I mean, they're talking in Japanese. I have no idea what they're saying, but it's really, really annoying. In my opinion, I'm leaving it on here so you guys can hear it. But one thing that is very nice is you can turn the voice volume down independent of the sound effects and the music. So you don't like the voices, you can just turn them right off. I dig that. Very, very cool. So if you're familiar with shmups at all, I'm doing this video from the perspective of someone who understands sort of what shmups are and what are a lot of the core tenets and mechanics of them. So that's kind of what I'm coming into this with. If you don't really have much of an understanding of the shmup genre, particularly the harder core Japanese shmups, this might be a bit lost on you, though I will say if you're looking to try that genre out, this is not a bad thing to start with, because it is relatively simple in comparison to some of them and gives you a good grasp of the mechanics. So your goal in this ultimately is to get to the end of each stage and get as high a score as you possibly can. You do that by taking enemies out, and in this game, you do them by taking them out quickly. So you see there's a score multiplier there on the left side. That goes up every time you take enemies out, so you see the bar is filling and then the actual multiplier itself goes up, and it goes up faster in rewarding of aggression is the way that the developers put it. So you want to get right up in enemies' faces if you can and take them out quickly and by being very close to them. That's obviously more risky because you don't have nearly as much time to dodge their bullets that they fire at you, but you're rewarded for that by increasing your multiplier a lot higher, and as you're fighting for leaderboard placement, you obviously want to do that. This game does have local leaderboards and online leaderboards. Now, I am playing this a little in advance of launch, a couple of days before it comes out. The leaderboards are working in that I can see them and I can file scores to them, but my scores are never showing up. So I'm hoping that's not a bug and that they have just locked filing to the leaderboards until the game comes out to prevent, you know, press who had early access to it from, you know, gaming the leaderboards more than the community. I have no problem with that if that's what they're doing. We'll see at launch if that's the case. I mean, if you can't file scores to the leaderboard, that's a bit of a big problem, right? So, yeah, so we're going through here. So you have multiple different levels of power intensity for your main gun that you can get by picking up those little P power-ups that you saw there that drops from certain enemies. You also have bombs. And that's what they do. So a bomb will clear out low-level enemies from the screen and will also do a lot of damage to bosses. You have a limited number of those, and you also get very large point bonuses at the end of levels for any bombs that you did not use. So you can have up to three, and if you don't use them by the end of the level, you will be rewarded very heavily for that. But of course, it's also risk-reward, right? So you're getting how this works. Now, in a lot of games like this, so what you're seeing here is what's often referred to as bullet hell, which is basically the screen gets filled with enemy bullets, often in very beautiful artistic patterns. Obviously, you need to dodge those as much as you can, and when things get really intense, there's often very small gaps you have to dodge through, and you got to be very careful with how you squeeze through it, right? And we'll talk about those extra bonuses after. So you see, there's my bomb bonus. You also get an additional very large bonus for what's called no miss, which is not quite what it sounds. It makes it sounds like you're. It could either be don't miss any enemies or don't get hit. It's actually just don't die. So as long as you don't die in a level, you will get that bonus. So there we are. So you can get up to, I believe it's four different power levels for your guns. Obviously, just makes them more powerful. If you have bombs left at the end of the level, you'll get extra bonuses. If you die, your bombs get refilled. If you complete a level, they do not get refilled. So, that again, you know, it's a way to keep the challenge up there. Now, one thing that this game does do that a lot of bullet hells don't is if you have enemies in a level that fire a large number of bullets at you and you take out that enemy, the bullets still stay on the screen. So you have to manage future enemies that are coming on the screen while at the same time dodging the bullets from the ones that were already there, even if you've taken them out. One of the innovations that Bullet Soul does that I haven't personally seen in any other shmup, though that it could have been done out there, is this interesting mechanic of when you destroy an enemy, any bullets that specific enemy fired become harmless. So you see as I'm killing enemies here that have shot bullets at me, they're turning sort of white and transparent. Those bullets are harmless at that point. So if you can take out an enemy fast enough, including various different stages of a boss, boom, there you go. That stuff clears out and it's harmless to you. And it's interesting because I think it's a neat mechanic because the bullet pattern continues to fill out, but it's also harmless. So if you can actually pay attention to that as you play, you can get a good idea of what the enemy's bullet pattern is so that in the future, it might make it easier for you to dodge it as you go. So it's not, it encourages you to take out the enemy quick, but also sort of pay attention after the fact. I think that's a neat little innovation actually. And as you can see, I'm getting a lot of these extra score pop-ups here. So the levels are full of special enemies and special bonus types. Now, these are not explicitly defined, though there are different types of them. Some of them are for, I think, taking out enemies with a certain degree of speed. Others are for taking out certain extra hidden enemies. that mystery bonus there is for taking out those little green boxes, and it's literally just little incentivized bonuses that reward skilled play. They're not required, obviously, but if you can get them, once again, your placement on the leaderboards gets higher, so you want to try to max that out if you can. Now, the other thing you may be saying to yourself at this point is, this doesn't seem to be particularly hard. And to a certain degree, you would be right. The first couple of stages of this game are actually not that tough. You know, if you've never played a shmup before, this is probably already looking very intimidating to you, but it's something you learn to grasp fairly quickly. And it's definitely not the hardest shmup in the world. I mean, there are some shmups out there that will kick the living crap out of you right from the word go, and there are others that are very casual and very easy. One of the things I like about the shmup genre is the incredible amount of variety that's in it. There's different types of shmups out there for almost everybody, and the really advanced shmups actually have a number of different modes in them that allow you to play them either super hardcore or more casually if you want, all within the same game. There's a number of titles out there that do that, which I think is really cool. So this game starts off very easy. It kind of lulls you into a false sense of security. The first couple of levels you can usually beat without too much difficulty, and then it gets much tougher. I mean, even this boss here is quite a bit tougher, because you can see it's got much more intense bullet patterns and a much larger life bar. Like, even though I'm pumping rounds into this thing, it's ticking down very, very slowly, whereas the boss in the first level, I kind of chewed through with little effort, right? So that's something to keep in mind. I would recommend, if you haven't played shmups before or just want to get more used to this, I would probably start with the Mode B variant, which definitely seems to be easier. Also, if you beat, if you achieve certain targets, which it vaguely defines in the manual, but if you achieve certain targets, you will get what's called the second loop after beating the final boss. Well, the game has five stages, which is normal as well in shmups. And when you beat the final boss, you can get the second loop, which is you play the game again, but it's harder. So it's like a new game plus type deal. And the true final boss, you will only encounter at the end of that second run. So, you know, it requires a fair amount of work to get the real final true ending if you want to put that time in. I have not seen the final boss yet. I got to the second loop in Mode B, but then I got wrecked pretty quickly. You can continue, of course, but this being a shmup with a proper scoring system, your score does reset if you continue. So if you want to get maximum leaderboard placement, you obviously need to do this in one credit. If you don't, well then, if you don't, you can play through and sort of brute force your way to the end of the levels and the quote unquote story if you want. But you want best leaderboard placement, you got to do it in one credit. So, I mean, games that don't reset your score when you continue, I mean, there's basically no point in them having a high score table. I've said that before. So, yeah, you're kind of getting the idea here. It is relatively simplistic compared to some other shmups. It has a good amount of variety, at least in this PC version. Definitely not as much as some other shmups do, but it's definitely still pretty good. It has a decent challenge. I think the bullet pattern design is pretty good. It's got a pretty good scoring system that rewards aggression and rewards, really digging in and rewarding people who choose to put in the effort to try to maximize things. But it doesn't require it of you. If you just want to play through a shmup and you don't even really care about scores, this does give you the means to do that. But it will reward those who really want to dig in and fight for the best leaderboard placement, which I enjoy. And it's got some variants on that, like the caravan mode and the stage attack mode and things like that. It's not just simply play through the main game over and over again and, you know, try to get the best full run. If you want to focus on a certain part of it to try to get the best possible score in a certain element, it gives you the options to do that, which I quite appreciate. I think it's a good way to go about it. So you're sort of seeing this here. So I'm going to go back to the main menu here. I'm going to show you a couple of the other characters here. Let's just go into Caravan and I'll show you how this works. So this guy has probably the worst voice acting in the whole game. It's just, he sounds like he's constipated constantly. It's pretty hysterical. So I'll show you here as we begin to pick up power-ups and use bombs and stuff. Like, I kind of laughed the first time I played this guy, because I was just like, oh my god, why is that considered a good addition to it? It's just, oof. It's pretty cringy. But again, you can turn it off independently, which is more than a lot of games let you do. So I will give credit where credit's due for that. If you want it, you can, you got it, but it's not required of you, to be sure. So, but you can see this guy here has quite a bit of a different type of gun, right? He's got like a weird drill bit, like a bullet drill bit or something that comes out in front of him. It's really strange, but it's different. Each character does play. So let me see if I can. Oh, I don't actually have. Right, you don't have bombs in caravan mode. Derp. So, which is unfortunate because I really would like to. I really would like to show you that. Maybe I'll show you that after this caravan run is done. But yeah, each character does have different weapon varieties and does play quite a bit different than each other. So you can play the game through multiple ways and have a bit of a different play experience each time. It is definitely not, again, it is definitely not as varied as some other shmups. You know, at the end of the day, you are still firing a massive hail of bullets forward, and that's kind of the core element of it, right? This is really not doing justice to the terrible voice acting here. I really need to do a different thing here, but got about 30 seconds left here. So, you can see here, so we're sort of fighting a mid-boss here, right? So the scrolling is stopped. So obviously, if you can deal with this quickly, it'll start rolling forward again, and you can get more enemies to take out. So you really want to, again, this game rewards aggression, so you really want to be as aggressive as possible, especially in a mode like this, which is about time score attack and getting as far into the stage as you possibly can. So let's see what we can do here. Interestingly as well, you also get an option you have the option of filing to the leaderboard. So you'll see here, you can set your name, and it will actually remember the name between runs, so you don't have to specify it every time, which is a nice little touch that I like. So see, it's already set in there. So there's the local leaderboards. So it's that mode as that guy. So you see, you can choose to register on the leaderboards or not. It always says ranking has been updated, but as I said, right now, if I were to go in and look here, as you can see here, yeah, I'm not on here. Like, I'm telling it to pull up my score, and it's not. So I'm thinking these are mostly developers or beta testers or things like that. I wouldn't be surprised to see this get reset at the end of the at release. I was going to say the end of the beta. This game's technically not in beta. I am playing the final version. And then we have Bancho mode here. So let's just pick, let's just say stage 2. Yeah, you see what I mean? It's like, here we go. It's just, oh my god, it's terrible. This guy is by far the worst, but they're all pretty cringy in their own way. So, yeah, it's pretty ridiculous. But hey, you know, you can turn it off if you want. So yeah, you're sort of seeing the core of it here. As shmups go, I will say that this is a bit of a more basic package. You know, this is not Mushihimi Sama. It's definitely not the absolute bonkers variety of something like Darius vs. Chronicle Saviors or anything like that. It's definitely, it doesn't have the interesting variety of, say, some of the Triangle Service shmups, or even a lot of the cave shmups. I mean, Mushihimi Sama is a cave shmup, so, you know, there's definitely a, in terms of variety, and especially in terms of difficulty, you can definitely do, there's definitely, I would say, potentially better options out there than this. But I think if you want a shmup that's still fun and can be challenging for those who want to put in the work and has, I would say, one unique mechanic and a good implementation of other ones that have already been done, this is pretty cool. You know, I think it's all right. Technically, it could be better. I wish it had higher resolution options than 720p, but, I mean, you saw in the options menu there is still a ridiculous amount you can do with this in spite of the resolution limitation, and it still looks fine to me in this regard. Obviously, the play area only takes up a small amount of the screen. That's not unusual for shmups, because most shmups are designed to be played on a vertically oriented monitor, which is why this is squeezed so much. I mean, for a vertical shmup like this, that's really kind of required. So some people may be turned off by that. I mean, it's pretty much par for the course, so it doesn't really bother me. But I think this is a good, potentially a good entry point for people who don't have a lot of experience with shmups and are intimidated by some of the more hardcore yet excellent ones like Ikaruga or something like that. But I think this has some hardcore appeal as well. I don't actually know its price right now. Strangely enough, even though it comes out in a couple of days after I'm recording this, the price has not been announced. It was $15 on the Xbox 360. The general consensus in the community is that this is probably going to be $10 or $15 on Steam when it comes out, which I think is a fair price for this. Though, if you're someone who might want to one and done a shmup like this, like, you know, just play it and get to the end once and be like, all right, that's it, then that might be a little bit too rich for your blood. Certainly understandable. One thing I like about shmups as well is that while they look decent, they are relatively low in terms of technical fidelity. So if you want a good genre that you could play on a non-gaming laptop or something like that, I haven't tried this on a system with integrated graphics, but I imagine it would run fine on those. These are a very good option for that. This does have cloud saves, so it will sync over your settings and your local high score tables to Steam Cloud, so you can access it on multiple systems, which is kind of nice. So it's a good option for that. You know, this genre as a whole is a pretty good option for that if you're just looking for a technically lighter game that can run on a lot of different things. I think that that's a good option for that. But yeah, I'm enjoying this. It's not my favorite shmup, definitely not. But I think it's a good time for what it is. And if the price is right, I think you can do pretty well with this. And obviously, one of the things I love is that, you know, shmups like this typically were something that you only saw not only on consoles, but only in an import sense. A lot of the times, if you wanted to play games like this before, you had to import retail discs from Japan for insane prices, and a lot of the times you had to have a modded console to play them as well. It's made me really happy that in the last few years we've started to see a lot more of these games make it to Steam. I mean, the PC gaming, to be frank about it, PC gaming is really not a thing in Japan. There isn't much of a community there for the most part, but the Japanese developers are starting to realize, because the shmup is becoming an increasingly niche genre. It's becoming very hard to make money in it. It has a very, very loyal following in the community, but it doesn't have much of one. And you need to get this out on a place where you're going to reach a wide audience in order to make to potentially make decent money at it. And it makes me really happy that a lot of these small developers in Japan, I mean, most of these games are only made by a couple of people, right? This is made by a couple of established teams. It's made by, the developer has the most Japanese name I've ever heard. They're called the Five Power and Games, abbreviated as 5PB. And they're actually not just a game developer, they're also a record label, which is really odd. And this is published by a company called Mages Inc., which has done a whole bunch of Japanese titles. And they focus on very niche genres. And it makes me really happy to see these games coming to Steam now, where people can access them on a wide scale, and you don't need an imported console, and you don't need to pay a bazillion dollars to get a retail copy of one of these games to play it. You can get it relatively cheap on Steam, because they're realizing that it's not that hard to port these games over, and Steam makes it very easy to get your game out to an audience without having to pay through the nose for it as a developer. The shmup community seems to be embracing it, and even though this game is a few years old and definitely looks it, I'm really happy to see that this came out here. And yeah, more choice for shmups is always a good thing, in my opinion. So yeah, that is Bullet Soul, developed by The Five Power and Games, and published by Mages Inc. Well, originally in 2011, this version is coming out in 2017 on the PC. It's got some limitations, and it's not shmup of the century, to be sure, but I actually quite enjoy it. And I think this is a good starting point and something veterans can probably find some fun in too. Thanks for watching, everybody. If you liked what you saw here, please consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel. That does help me out a great deal. If you want to watch something else, check out the videos on screen now. And don't forget to follow @PXA Media on Twitter to find out about new stuff first.